it's Missy. Thank you for watching. For today's video, I was inspired by prom, but prom might be past by the time this video goes up, so maybe this can just be 3 spring hairstyles. Either way, I hope you learned something from today's video. Like and subscribe, click that notification bell so you never miss any future uploads, and let's get started. For the updo, I'm going to begin with my hair parted on the right side. Then I'm going to divide out a section of hair on the left side of my head from the part down to my ear. I'm going to clip this hair aside to use for the braid later on. Now I'm going to pin the crown section. So I'm going to divide off a section of hair from the sides of my head going towards the back of my head. And I'm going to slightly twist this hair towards the left side and then pin it in place using a couple bobby pins. Then I'm going to go back over the crown section and gently pinch and pull on small pieces of hair to loosen them, and this will create some volume and dimension in the crown section. Now I'm going to create the bun portion of the hairstyle. So I'm first dividing out a few pieces of hair to frame my face on the right side, and then I'm going to combine the remaining hair together at the nape of my neck. Using an elastic band, I'm going to tie the hair together into a ponytail. And once it's all tied off, I'm going to create a rope braid with my ponytail to use to create the bun. So I'm going to split the ponytail into 2 equal sections. Then I'm going to cross the left section over the right while also twisting the 2 sections towards the left side. And I'm going to continue this pattern working down to the ends of the hair. And then once the whole section is twisted up, I'm going to wrap this twist into the bun. So I'm going to wrap it clockwise around the base of the ponytail so it creates the shape of the bun. And then using bobby pins, I'm going to pin the hair in place. So I'm going to slide them into the hair so it secures the twist against my head. And I like to slide these in towards the center of the bun so they stay hidden underneath the hair. And I just put one in wherever I'm holding the hair with my fingers. So I just work my way around the bun, pinning it wherever it feels loose. And then with the ends, I'm going to tie an elastic band over these to keep them combined together. And then I'm going to tuck them under the bun and pin them in place using another bobby pin. Now I'm going to create the braid portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to let down the hair on the left side of my head and divide off a small section near the part to begin my braid. I'm creating a fishtail braid, so I'm going to start the braid like a regular 3-strand braid by crossing the 2 side strands once over the middle strand. Then by combining 2 of the strands together, I can switch to a fishtail braid. So I'm essentially taking small pieces from one side and crossing them over and combining them into the opposite side section. I'm also going to be incorporating new sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid to create a lace style braid. This type of braid will give the hairstyle an overall softer look. So to create the fishtail braid, I'm crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side, while also picking up new sections of hair from underneath the bottom of the braid and crossing these over the top, adding them into the top or right section of the braid. So I'm taking a small piece from the right side and crossing it over to the left. I'm taking a small piece from the left side, crossing it over to the right, picking up a new section of hair and crossing it over to the right side as well. I'm taking a small piece from the right side and crossing it over to the left. I'm taking a small piece from the left side and crossing it over to the right, while also picking up a new section of hair from the bottom side of the braid and crossing it over, adding it into the right side as well. And I'm going to create the braid along the left side of my head, and as I am braiding, I'm also going to make sure to leave out small sections of hair along the hairline to frame my face once the style is done. So I'm continuing the lace style fishtail braid, working my way along the left side of my head until I've brought in all of the hair that I want to on this side. Then once that's done, I'm simply going to continue braiding the fishtail braid a little further down by crossing small sections of hair from one side over to the opposite side to ensure the braid will reach around the back of my head so I can pin it above the bun at the back. So once the braid reaches far enough, I'm going to bring it around the back of my head and lay it above the top of the bun. Then I'm going to fold it under and pin it in place using bobby pins. Again, I like to pin the braid from the right side.
And I also like to slide them underneath the hair so they don't stick out and show. Then I can kind of go back over the braid and gently pull on the edges to make the braid look a little bit wider so it's easier to see. And I'm also going to just make sure to pin down any ends that are still sticking out with some bobby pins. To create the half-up style, I'm going to start with my hair parted slightly off-center. Then I'm going to divide off sections of hair in front of both of my ears. Now I'm going to divide off the crown section and pin this in place. I'm going to catch a little hair in my bobby pin. Then I'm going to flip the pin towards the left side and push it in towards the right side horizontally. And I usually use two pins to secure this section of hair. Now with the front section of hair on the left side, I'm going to use this to create a braid. So first I'm going to divide off a few pieces to leave out that will frame my face. And then I'm going to take a section above my ear and split this into three pieces to begin the braid. I'm starting the braid a little bit lower on the section right above my ears. And I'm going to create a three-strand braid while also incorporating sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid. So I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand while also picking up new sections of hair from underneath the braid, and I'm bringing these into the braid along the bottom side of the braid, and this will create a lace style braid and help give the overall style a softer look. I brought in about 3 to 4 sections of hair until it reached the center of the back of my head. And then I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the edges so small pieces of the braid will loosen and slide out to make it appear wider and more full. And then I'm going to tuck the braid under itself and use a couple bobby pins to pin it in place at the center of the back of my head right underneath the crown section. I slide the bobby pins into the braid on the right side and just make sure to slide them underneath the hair so they don't show or stick out anywhere. And now I'm going to repeat those steps and create a second braid on the right side of my head with the hair that I had previously clipped away. So I'm dividing out a few pieces to stay out and frame my face. And then I'm dividing off a section to use for my braid. I want these braids to start a little lower, so I'm beginning the crossovers closer to my ears. This will give the style an overall softer look as well. So again, I'm crossing the side strands over the middle strand. And I'm incorporating new sections of hair into the bottom side of the braid to create a lace style braid. I brought in about 3 to 4 sections of hair until it reached the center of the back of my head. And then I'm going to go back over the braid and carefully pull on the edges so small pieces of the braid will loosen and slide out to make it appear wider and more full. And once I've brought in about 3 to 4 sections and the braid reaches the center of the back of my head, I'm going to pull the braid through the braid from the left side. So I'm going to create a small gap in the left braid that's already pinned and then carefully pull the right braid through this gap. And once the braid is pulled through the other braid and lined up with the left braid, then I'm going to pin it in place with a couple more bobby pins. And again, I want to make sure to hide the pins underneath the hair so they don't show. And I just like to slide them in horizontally so they basically line up with the braids. And I only used about 2 bobby pins. You can use more if you prefer. And you can also slide one into the center of the braid if it's drooping just slightly. This will help hold it in place as well. For the next hairstyle, I'm going to begin by pinning the crown section first. So I'm going to trace lines with my fingers along the sides of the top of my head, meeting at the back of my head to divide off this crown section. Then I'm going to slightly twist the section together and pin it in place. And I usually use 2 bobby pins to hold in this section of hair, just as a little added security. Now I'm going to divide off a small section of hair on the left side, next to the crown section just underneath it, and create a twist with this section of hair. So I'm going to twist the hair upwards and then gently pull on the bottom side of the twist so part of the hair slides out, making the twist look fuller. And then I'm going to lay the twist under the crown section and pin it in place with bobby pins. I'm sliding mine into the right side of the twist at the center of the back of my head so they go in horizontally along the twist. And then I'm going to take a new section of hair on the right side of my head and create another twisted section. So I'm twisting the section upwards and bringing it around the back of my head so it meets at the other twist. And then I'm going to tuck it underneath the left twist. So I'm going to pull the right twist underneath the left and then pin it in place with a couple bobby pins. And once it's pinned, I can go back over the twist and gently pull on small sections to make the twist look a lot fuller. And then I'm going to twist one more section of hair from the left side of my head and pin this underneath the previous two twists. So I'm dividing off a section of hair from the left side of my head and twisting this hair upwards. Then I'm going to carefully pull on the bottom portion of the twist to make it look a lot wider and more full. Then I'm going to lay it underneath the two other twists and pin it against my head using some more bobby pins. And now I'm going to create the ponytail portion of the hairstyle. So I'm going to combine the remaining hair together and tie it into a low ponytail. And now I'm going to create a topsy tail. So what I'm going to do is carefully pull the elastic band down slightly, and then I'm going to create a gap in the hair right above the elastic. Then I'm going to flip the ponytail up and through the gap so the two side sections are twisted. Then I'm going to gently pull on the two sides to make the twists look a lot bigger. And I just want to pull on small sections of hair. I don't want to pull on the entire section, just little pieces to make it look a little bit bigger. And then as a last step to cover the elastic band, I'm going to divide off a small section of hair from the ponytail, wrap this around the elastic band, and then of course pin it against the wrapped piece using a bobby pin on the underside.
That wraps up today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure to comment down below which of the three hairstyles was your favorite. This really helps me out for future videos, knowing which ones you guys like to see so that I know which ones to do more of in the future. Be sure to like and subscribe. Click that notification bell as well so you never miss any future uploads, and I will see you next time.